Hi guys, welcome to surface area of a square pyramid. Behind me displayed are two diagrams showing a square pyramid, which we're going to work out the total exterior covering surface outside area. Now over here we have a kind of like the pyramid happening here, and it's a three-dimensional version in this diagram. And once we flatten this out and spread it out into the exterior covering or the surface area, it kind of looks like this type of a net. Now, with a square pyramid, we have how many faces? Yes, we have five faces. We have one, two, three, four, four triangles. And the fifth face is the bottom base, the square part of this particular pyramid. Now, there's something very important about this pyramid that we need to work out. But first, all units are in centimeters. So the final area will be in centimeters squared, and we're looking for an answer in two decimal places. So let's check this out. There's one thing we need to check out first before we can actually work out the surfaces of all five of these faces, and that is to work out the slant height. What do I mean? Well, if we look at this diagram here, let's take a closer look and examine all the distances and dimensions on it. What we have is the base of the square pyramid, which is 10 centimeters by 10 centimeters. That's this part here, 10 by 10, that's the square there. And we also have the vertical height from the apex all the way to the center of that square down here, perpendicular and vertical. Now that vertical height is 12 centimeters right there. Now we can't use that 12 centimeters, it's pretty good for volumes but not surface area, because that height is not attached to the surface, because we got to work out the area of the surface, not the interior. So what do we need to do? Well, we need to work out this red dotted line right there. And that red dotted line forms a triangle, if you can see that triangle there. And that triangle is what we're after, because we're going to use that later. We're going to use a guy named Pythagoras to help us work out what that slant length there is. Now, let me show you what that length there is across here on the flat net diagram. And that's this length across here. Now that's the slant length here, but here it's actually the perpendicular vertical height of each triangle. So this particular triangle, we need to find that height, we have the base, and we can work out the area of that triangle and subsequently all the other three triangles. Then all we have to do is add the square in the middle, and we have the complete, total, entire surface area covering of this square pyramid. So stay tuned for part two. We're about to jump in and work out the surface area of this pyramid, so stay tuned.
Take a minute to check out our website at http://www.vividmaths.com. You'll find additional resources, cheat sheets, transcripts, and other maths videos that are not available on YouTube. Lastly, don't forget to subscribe to get access to all the written answers for your math questions, plus other special offers.